Just give you some example problems, then you will understand. So maybe the question is integrate. Okay, the word I am using here, integrate. So if I write integrate, then you will understand this is to do the integration. So it is written integrate with respect to x. So with respect to x means we will write dx at the end, so that will be the with respect to x. Okay, so question number one, say it is 5x square minus 3x plus 4. So this is, I will give the square later, just wait. So another question is say 3 root over x, okay, minus 4 sine x plus 2 by x, or 2 by x. Okay, so I'm writing the third question. It is a 5 cos x plus 2 e to the power x, then minus say x to the power something something. Okay, and then I'm writing another question. Say it is 3x minus 2 by x whole square. Okay, so I will complete the questions by writing now. So I will complete the question by pencil. Say the first question is 5x square. 5x square minus 3x plus 4. Second question is 3 into root over x. And the next part is okay. Third question, 2 e to the power x, and then minus x to the power 3.2, x to the power 3.2, this is decimal point. And fourth question is 3x minus 2 by x whole square. So you write all these questions so that you can move on, you can understand. So fifth number question is something we did in the last class, but still just let me do it again. 2x cube plus 3x and then plus 7 by x square. Okay. So this is the third, fifth question. So these are the questions. Now I will show you one by one. So is that okay? Everyone is okay with the questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So everyone is okay with the question. Okay. So let me do it one by one. And number one, whenever you start answering, you always write the question first. That is integration symbol, and then the whole question within a bracket, and then dx you put at the end. So in this question, we are putting dx because it is mentioned in the question with respect to x. So be careful. Maybe most of the time it will be with respect to x, but it is not mandatory that every time it will be dx. Okay, so with respect to x means dx. So if it is another variable, then you will have to use that variable. So first question is this, and the first thing you will do, separate. So if you do the separation with the three parts given, The first part will be, sorry, there should be dx. The first part will be 5x square, then dx, and then you continue with the second part. Second part is again minus, then integration, then 3x, then dx. Third part is plus, then integration 4 dx. So now tell me what will be the result for the first part. It is 5, just a number, so 5 will be written at the front, and then the
x cube by 3, sir.
X cube by 3. So everyone is okay with this idea, or you have some problem?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this is the x to the power n formula, and x to the power n formula in integration is this. So we are using the x to the power n integration formula. So it is x to the power 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 for the second part. And what will be the third part?
4x.
So everyone is okay with this 4x?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If anyone has any problem, please let me know, because if you have problem, if you do not understand, then we should not proceed with next things. Okay, it should be very clear at this level. So 5 by 3 x cube, and then 3 by 2 x square, then plus 4x. So I told you any constant will be like this. If it is 3, then it will be 3 into x. If it is 7, then 7 into x. Do not ever write 0. Okay. That is the differentiation formula. So let me show you the second question. Okay. Again, you will start in the same way. That means you will write down the whole question with integration sign. So if you do not show the integration symbol, then it is meaningless. It doesn't mean anything. Okay. Just you are not doing something, you are writing the question and then you are writing the answer. It is meaningless. If you do integration, there will be a certain answer. If you do differentiation, there will be another answer. Okay, answer is not always same. So answer depends on what you are actually doing. So if you do not show what you are doing, then how the answer is coming? So I cut some marks from some of you in the midterm exam, because for differentiation also, you did not show ddx. If you do not show ddx, then how can I know that you are doing ddx and you are getting particular answer? Okay. So be careful on that integration part as well. You have to show the integration symbol and dx at the end. Both are important. So tell me, what will be this answer?
3 into x to the power half plus 1 by half plus
3 into x to the power 3 by 2.
That is the real formula here. So you can directly write 3 by 2. Possible, but for today, for the beginning, we are showing the calculation here. This is the formula. The original power is half. Because of root x, the original power is half. So with the x to the power n formula, we will get this. And the second part. Second part
plus
is what?
4 cos x.
Plus 4 cos x. Because ddx of integration sine x is minus cos x. So we need to use that minus sign as well. So what about the third part?
2 into x to the power minus
2 ln x.
Plus 1 by
2 ln x.
Sir, we can, I think we can do.
Yes, sir. 2 ln x.
But which is suitable? So I was waiting for this problem actually for asking that.
Yeah, I know, that is why
2 into 1 by x, 1 by x square.
Yes, complete
2 ln x answer.
Okay, so 2 ln x, this is the correct answer. So the question is why it is not x to the power n formula? Why not?
Yes, sir.
Because
you can write it like 2 x inverse 1.
No, so it will be infinity if you do it like.
Okay. So Navid Nauruz.
Yes, sir. You showed us last class.
Yes. So it is not the appropriate formula for this. I mean, I am saying the same thing again. Let me just show you again. That is, here I am writing in red color. ddx of ln x. Okay, what is the ddx of ln x?
1 by x.
That is 1 by x. So if you do integration of this result, it has to be the original one. This is the rule. I mean, there is no understanding, no new thing, no old thing. Every time you have to keep this in your mind that differentiation is directly opposite to integration, or integration is directly opposite to differentiation. So when ddx of ln x is 1 by x, then integration 1 by x is ln x. There is no question about that. So just keep this in your brain. So this is one reason. Another thing is, in the formula actually there is a restriction. This is the formula. What is the formula? Formula is, we already know, integration x to the power n formula. So in that formula it is given, this will be x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, but there is a restriction. X cannot be n. This is n. It is not x, the power. N cannot be minus 1. There is a restriction in the formula. You understand, Azharuddin?
Yes, sir.
So there is a restriction given in the formula that if the power is minus 1, then this formula will not work. Then there will be another formula, and that formula is integration 1 by x. This is the another formula. 1 by x means x to the power minus 1.
Minus 1. Yes, sir.
So when x power has minus 1, that formula will be different, the ln x formula. This x to the power n formula will not work. And the third logic is, Navid has told you already, that is, if you even try to apply this formula, in this case it will be x to the power minus 1 plus 1 divided by minus 1 plus 1. So that will be something by 0. So something by 0 is infinity. It is not the, I mean, reachable answer or understandable answer. So for all these reasons, actually, we are not using x to the power n formula here. So it will be 2 ln x. And finally, you will write the answer, what you have got here. So this is 3 and divided by 3 by 2. So you can just write it like 2 only. No, 3 by 2. Oh, no.
Yes, sir.
9 by 2 by 3. Isn't it only 2? Yes, correct.
No, sir, 2. Only 2. 6
yes.
by 3.
So it is okay. Okay. Let me just...
Sir, right. 6 x to the power 3 by 2.
Yes, so 6 or 2?
6 x to the power 3 by 2.
6 or only 2?
So only two of them.
Are only two. Two.
Only two. Two x to the power 3/2.
Two, sir.
Two x to the power 3/2.
So two x to the power 3/2, and then plus 4x. Cos x. And then plus 2 ln x, and then plus c. So that's it. So this is the answer. Now let me just erase the first part. Okay, erase the first part so that I can continue with the third question. So if you are not done, you can just copy this second question. Let us start with the third one. So this is the third question. Again, you start in the same way. So you start writing the full question. You start writing like integration, and then third question, 5 cos x plus 2 e to the power x, and then minus x to the power 3.2, and then close the bracket, then dx, then move into the next line. The same thing, separate part by part. So it will be 5 cos x dx is the first part. Then integration 2 e to the power x dx is the second part. And then integration x to the power 3/2 dx is the third part. And then move to the next line. So it is 5 into sine x. So 5 into sine x, because integration cos x dx is just sine x, not minus. Okay, so that's all. And then plus integration 2 e to the power x is just 2 e to the power x, same thing. And then minus x to the power 3.2. So that will be the same formula, like x to the power 3.2 plus 1. So it is 4.2, and divided by 3.2 plus 1. So 4.2. So point is not a problem here. Any power, any number. That's all. Okay. So that will be the answer for the third question. Now let us move to the fourth question. If anyone has any problem with this, you can ask me. Anyone has any problem? This is easy. There should not be any problem, actually. Is that okay? Can I move to the fourth question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us move to the fourth question. So question number 4 is also same. You start with the integration sign. And then the question, so you write the whole question every time. I am telling it to you many times, repeatedly, every time. Do not just write the question and write the answer. No, you write it with the integration symbol, then you can write the answer in the next line. So this is the question, and here we will apply algebra formula for making it ready to do the integration. So we need to apply the a minus b whole square formula here in this example. So that will be a square. A square means 9x square, and then minus 2ab. So what will be the answer? Minus 2 into a into b.
What is
12? Yes, correct. So I am writing 12 directly. It is actually a square minus 2ab plus b square. That is the formula we are applying here. This is not integration. This is just algebra formula. We are expanding a minus b whole square. So you now make it ready by separating three parts here. So first part is 9x square dx, second part is 12 dx, third part is 4 by x square dx. So you now apply the appropriate formula. So what will be 9x square?
9x cube by 3.
X cube by 3, correct. So everyone is okay with this? This should be 2 plus 1 and 2 plus 1. So x cube by 3. What is the second part?
12x.
12x. Everyone is right. So everyone is okay with 12x, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then third one. What is the third part?
X to minus 1 by minus 1.
Yes. So it will be x to the power minus 2 is the original power. So x to the power minus 2 is the original power. We are applying the integration formula. So it is minus 2 plus 1. So minus 2 plus 1 means minus 1 and then divided by minus 1. So you put C here. You can write another line. That line will be the final answer. 3x cube and then minus 12x. Then minus 4 by minus 1. So only minus 4. Minus 4 x to the power minus 1. So you can write minus 4 divided by x possible. If you write in that way, that is also correct. If you write x to the power minus 1, that is also okay. So okay with this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let me move on for the last problem. In that case also, for the fifth question, you need to do some simplification. So do some simplification in this case means you are separating the fractions. Okay, actually there will be three fractions. So you will separate the fractions and then you will do the integration later. So in the beginning, you write the question in the same way. Integration, then the whole question 2x cube, then plus 3x, then plus 7 divided by x square. So dx should be mentioned, and then you separate the three fractions here. 2x cube by x square is one fraction, and then 3x by x square is another fraction, okay, and 7 by x square is another fraction. So all have the same LCM. So there will be no problem with this. The first one is 2x dx, second one is 3 by x dx, third one is 7 by x square dx. So 7 by x square is the same thing what we have just done here, 4x square. So it will be similar result here also. Let me erase this part and continue with the next line. So the first answer will be what?
C square.
X square, because it will be 2 into x square by 2.
So it will only be x square, sir.
Right, only x square. So yes. Yes. So second part is what?
3 ln x.
3 ln x. Good. And third part?
7 x to the power minus 1 by minus 1.
Right. So there should be a minus and then 7 divided by x. Because x to the power minus 1, so this will be the answer. Actually 2 cancel, so that will be only x square. So this will be the answer for question number 4. Is it okay? Now you tell me, anyone has any problem with the basic integration formula? If you have,
No, sir.
Okay, so everyone has copied from this here, right? I will give you a practice sheet, worksheet also. So that will be with some problems like that. So in the exam also, I will not give you some, I mean, hard questions, and I will not give you any question out of the syllabus. So the question will be easy, but you need to practice. You need to do it at home. So now I will show you another formula that is called the U into V formula. Actually, in integration term, it is called integration by parts. Okay, so I am writing it here, integration by parts, and in another word, it is the U into V formula in integration. Okay, so you can call this integration by parts, or you can call this UV formula, all the same thing, doesn't matter. So now I am giving you the formula. This is the new one, and I will show you some problems also, not today. I will show you the problems in the next class. Let me just give you the formula today. Is it okay? You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in differentiation, that was called product rule, quotient rule. So that is the conventional name. So in integration, it is called integration by parts. And this is actually UV formula, same thing. So it is integration, then U into V dx. That is the left side, because we are doing the integration for U into V, two multiplication here. And like before, U and V both are the function of x. So there will be x inside u, there will be v inside u, there will be x in the inside v also. That means two parts, both have some x inside. If there is no x, if it is one is two, another is x square, then we will not consider this as u into v formula. It is not u into v formula. Why not? Because this part is only 2. There is no x inside. But if you write x into sin x, then it is u into v formula. Because there is x in u, there is x in v also. So that is the understanding. So we understand that in uv formula, every time there will be x inside u and there will be x inside v. So if it is the situation, what will be the formula in the right side? Now I am moving on the right side. So you will write, let me use different color, u outside of integration, okay? U outside of integration. So it is integration v dx.
Dx, okay. Yes.
Okay, and then minus sign
v integration u.
No, not like that. It is pretty different. Okay,
second bracket, so, du by dx.
Yes, so it is like this. Let me use another okay, let me use this second bracket here, same color, but this one is different color, ddx. The differentiation, yes, differentiation is coming here. So ddx of the outer part, that is u. So you said du dx, that is also correct. In fact, it is ddx of u. So what is my u part? U part is the outside part, what we did not do anything. So this outside part is this. And then after differentiation, you continue with integration. That is same integration what you have done with v. So v dx integration will be here, and then you complete the second bracket, finish that part, and then write dx. So red one, the red integration and red dx is connected, and the maroon color v dx with the maroon color integration. Okay, and one extra part is here. That extra part is for the u part, that means which is outside of integration in the beginning. So this is the formula. So it is little tricky, it is little different, and somebody can think, okay, how is it? They are like, if I want to do the integration for u into v, I need to do differentiation also. Yes, it is true. So you cannot learn integration before differentiation. You have to learn differentiation first, and then all these clear idea will help you to learn integration. So this is the thing, or this is the formula I wanted to tell you today. So that is all, and I will not show the problems today. So I will show you the problems and how this formula can be applied in the next class. I'm just giving you the formula to memorize, I mean to keep it in your brain, so that it will help you to do the problems in the next class. Is it okay? Do you understand?
Yes, sir.